Hey guys, welcome to Ghananie Photography. My name is Don Alabi. In today's video, I'll take you through 7 cool updates in the new captureone, that's captureone 20. I don't know why they've named it captureone 20 though, but I'll just guess it's because you are entering 2020. Otherwise, this is supposed to be captureone 13, but it's captureone 20. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, kindly do so and hit the bell button so you don't get to miss any of my tutorials. Welcome back guys. So as you are aware, I use captureone for my raw processing. I've never used Lightroom. I keep saying that. I'll take you through 7 reasons why I have updated and 7 good reasons why you should also make the switch if you haven't switched to captureone yet. Now let's get straight to business. First of all, if you use captureone, you realize that in the old version, if you come to the color tab and you come to the color editor under basic, this is not how it used to appear in the old one. It had a different interface. But in the new one, the basic color editor has a new interface. Now, the advanced and skin tones have the same thing, but the basic editor has a new interface. That's one. The next change that you will notice in this is if you come to the various tools, you realize in the old one, it used to be A, which is for the automatic adjust. But for now, we have this magic wand thing over here for each side that has to be A. So all the automatic, the A sign for automatic adjustments have been replaced by this magic wand, which makes sense. But I don't know, but A looked, you know, way more automatic to me than this magic wand. It will take some time for people who are used to the A to get used to this also. We move to the next one. If you look at the HDR, the high dynamic range tab, you realize that 2 additional sliders have been added. That's the white and black. Now, if you look at this image here, a reference image, I use the white background. So, under normal circumstances, if you go to highlight, this is what you see. This is left and this is right. This is what we see. Now double click to reset it. If you look at shadows, this is up, this is down. Awesome. Now let's take a look at the new sliders. This is white. If you adjust white, you're affecting only white. It doesn't affect the highlights. I hope you understand. Now if we adjust black also, it affects only the black, not the shadows. So you see, this is a very, very cool feature. So you can work on the blacks and whites without affecting the shadows and highlights. So let's go to the extreme. I want the blacks black and the whites very white. And now I can go ahead and adjust the highlights and shadows. See, so without even touching highlight and shadow, just white and black. Let's zoom in and see. So as you can see, this backdrop, let me alt, then do this temporarily. Look at the backdrop down there. It's very dirty. With this applied, already we have some cleanness here. Now let's take a highlight all the way up. You can realize already here in the raw processing, we've been able to clean the backdrop before even moving to Photoshop. And there is much detail in the hair. As you can see, there's detail everywhere over here. So this is a new feature, a very, very cool feature that I love. Let's reset everything and get back here. So let's move to the next one. If you notice in the older version, which is 12, the menus on the left here, you couldn't scroll. But with this new version, you can actually scroll through. Back then, you had to close one tab before you could open another one, that if the space here is full. But now see, we have all these here and you just scroll through and Charlie, this is so good. This is very, very good. One other cool feature added to this new version of captureone is the fact that these menus have now been labeled. In the previous versions, these were not there. The labels were not under the various tools here. You had to place your mouse on for the tooltip to appear, or you had to guess what it was doing. There are some of us who use the crop tool a lot because we always shoot with enough room, so we'll be able to crop it according to the size that we want in post. I'm one of such persons. If you use the old version, you realize that when you click on this, these edges weren't there. You had to, you know, just go to the edge and then pull it. Now, if you have a black backdrop, you couldn't see. You just had to guess. Especially if you use a predefined crop, you had to guess where it was, and then it was very, very frustrating. But in this new version, we have the edges there, as you can see. So you can just, even though it's white, you see white on white, but I can still see the edges. So I just hold and then drag. And life is good. So this takes us to the next cool feature. In the older version, once you're done cropping, you had to select a different tool to get out of the crop. But now, you just press enter and it takes you out of the crop. So guys, in a nutshell, these are the 7 cool updates that Capture One has implemented that I really love about this app. Thank you for watching, and if you haven't subscribed yet, please just go ahead and subscribe. And let me know in the comment section, are you a Capture One user? What about Capture One do you love? You have updated. Have you noticed any newer thing that I haven't stated there? If yes, let me know in the comment section down below. I hope this has been informative for you, and I would like to thank you for watching.